Well, this is how you make coffee when the power goes out. We used to do this every day, all day long, when I was young and growing up. This was the modus operandi. You have a coffee pot, of which there is an inner basket that you put your grounds in. On an empty pot, you put the ground level on, press it down. You put the lid on, press it down. And you'll notice that there are some markings there for how much water to put in it. And then you heat up the water manually, electrically, by gas, by a microwave. It don't matter. You just heat up the water and then you get it ready to pour in there. And of course, then you can see those marks on the inside if you look clearly enough. So this is a grandma, a grandmother's, mom's, dad's, my early years of marriage making coffee. My grandma had this little two-cupper. This is how she made coffee when she wanted some just for herself, and it was not enough for anybody else. It would make two good cups of coffee. And this is how I chose to boil water, and it's with our kettle. We got used to these kettles when we were overseas. Every hotel room had one instead of a coffee maker. And then they'd have instant coffee, tea bags, and other stuff, cocoa that you can make in the room. So we got used to this over there, and we have gone through a number of these over the past dozen years or so. Lo and behold, the water is boiling sufficiently enough for me to say it's time. Take this boiling water and pour it into the coffee pot. So here's what you do. You just reach over and you pour it into the top reservoir. And since I made just enough water for the coffee here, I'm not measuring on the side. I will just pour all of the water in. And then to make a sort of a vapor lock to make it take its time and to protect the water from getting too dirty, you put the lid on and you just let it sit there and it drips water into the coffee grounds. And then in a little bit, you'll have your cup of coffee. If you listen real close, you can hear the water dripping as it goes down through the grounds and into the pot below. Listen. So I'm waiting patiently for the water to drip. That's what you gotta do. Got one of my favorite cups from Winslow, Arizona, if anybody happens to know. And this is our old rotary dial phone that was given to us as a gift recently. It's been converted so that it will go into a regular phone jack. But this is the only phone in the house that will work when we lose power like we did last night. So it is appropriate that the telephone sits close to the coffee pot. Impatient, you can always pop the lid a little bit and look in and see how far down the water has gone. Getting close, about time for a good cup of coffee. Winslow, Arizona, and maybe if somebody will call me on the phone. Well, it's just finishing up dripping, so I'm gonna reach up and pour me a good, hold my finger on the lid so it doesn't come off. Pour me a good cup of coffee. Good to the last drop. Now, if you wanted to, you could take the lid off, take the reservoir off, take the grounds out, put the lid directly onto the pot, set the pot on the burner, and set the burner to low, and keep the coffee warm, because there ain't no electricity used on this thing. So, a little bit of old-fashioned coffee we made last night on our Coleman stove. And I'm enjoying a fresh pot of it here this evening, December the 20th, and gonna enjoy it to my heart's content.